Ooh, one of the worst feelings in the world is when you go as a content creator and take some photos and then get back to the office, get back to your house, you're about to edit them, you're about to put them out on social media, and they're super grainy. That ISO value was way too high. In this episode, I am going to talk about how to fix your grainy photos. Let's go into my phone to do it. All right, guys, we're in my phone, and I want to show you some of the ways that I use to fix those grainy videos. And I'm going to start by using Lightroom. If you guys don't have Lightroom, Lightroom is one of the apps through Adobe Suite that we find provides us the most power for creating those content videos for clients or for ourselves, even for your Instagram profiles. And it's worth the subscription. It does a little bit more than any of the other apps out there, even though I am going to show you a different way afterwards through your iPhone just to edit the photos themselves. So first of all, let me find a grainy photo that I took, and then I'm going to show you how we edit it. All right, super grainy photo. It was taken in low light on an iPhone, and you can just see that everywhere it's a little bit warped. The goal is now to fix this. Now the first thing I always do, my process in Lightroom, is I always click auto, and for us in this one being grainy, it gets a lot worse. So before I do anything else, before I change anything back, I'm going to go to detail and I'm going to try to smooth out some of these features. Now, the first thing I do is I go to noise reduction and I increase the noise reduction to try to remove some of it. And boom, some of it's gone. But there's another level of that. There's color noise reduction, which I play with to try to get rid of some of that color fade that comes into play with those high ISO shots as well. Now, right away, I just add 100 of both of those, and you can see it better, but it's not perfect yet. It's hard to fix it when it's that bad, but there's another trick that I use. I will take the detail down a little bit, and on this one, again, smooths it out, looks really good. And then the same thing with the color noise reduction. I move the detail down a bit, and you can see now that it's not perfect, but it's getting there, where a lot of that noise is gone. So the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to effects, and I don't want to add any noise back in. If I add texture clarity, it's going to add a little bit. But I will look at dehaze a bit to try to find a little bit more contrast into the feel of what we're putting together. Then on this one, I always use a little bit of vignette just to add a little bit of value to it. This one, I'm not going to add that much. I'm going to feather it out a little bit. Perfect. Now I'm going to go to light. Now contrast wasn't used earlier. I want to add a little bit of contrast. And you know what? I am going to add a tiny bit of texture just to try to add a little bit of those values back, maybe a tiny bit of clarity. And when I get into light, now I'm going to play with highlights a bit. I want a little bit more at the bottom. Got to go down a bit. And then my shadows play. Again, this is just about your personal feel. There's no right or wrong way to edit it at this point in time. You're trying to go for your style and your feel. Now, last thing, just going to fix up a little bit of the color. Boom. I like it. We got rid of a lot of grain. Again, it's not perfect, but for creating a quantity of content where not everything is perfect and you're trying to get touch points with your audience, this photo is completely fine to put on your Instagram profile if you got it to the point where it matches your feel and matches your brand. And that's really cool. You saved a shot that maybe you were really mad, didn't turn out good, and now you can still use it. So I'm gonna save that one. All right, guys, we saved that. Now, I'm going to go to photos on an iPhone. And recently, iPhone put out an update where they have some of those same features as that's on Lightroom. Now, it's not quite as good as Lightroom, but I want to show you how they work. So let me go find that same photo. There we go. And on my iPhone, I'm going to click Edit. Now, they got all these features at the bottom. Again, my process is I always go auto first. This one doesn't do it quite as strong as Lightroom did. And then I'm going to go right to the end here, and there's this section called noise reduction. This was just added in the recent update. And I'm just, for this one, going to go to full. Now, the one thing you'll notice is it doesn't get rid of as much noise as it did in Lightroom. So I'm going to go here, and I'm going to go definition. I can't add any, otherwise it's going to make it noisier again. Sharpness, same thing. If I try to add any, it's not going to help us out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through my normal process. I'm going to add a little bit of vignette to it. Vibrance on this one, let's add a little bit. Saturation, let's take down a tiny bit. Now, the trick with iPhone is you can't get rid of as much noise as you can on Lightroom, but you can remove a little bit of contrast a little bit towards the end, and it does help a tiny bit on getting rid of a little bit more and balancing everything out. All right, guys, done. Saving the photo. Now, I'm coming out of the phone. I want to talk about each of these. All right, guys, I am back. And what I got here is I got the iPhone edit to my right, and I got the Lightroom edit to my left. Now, the reason I want to show you this is that the Lightroom edit still is stronger. So if you can get that Adobe subscription, if you can get Lightroom, it's going to make a huge difference on the content you're creating for either your clients or for yourself. But at the same time, if you can't yet, the iPhone edit is still great. You got rid of some of that noise. All you got to do is try to focus on keeping those ISO values down and try to take shots with less noise in the beginning. But if you do take one and you're trying to save it, there is ways to make it happen. You don't just have to delete or discard those photos. That's it for this episode, guys. I hope you guys got a lot of value. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, hit that bell for notifications. I promise you won't regret it. My name is Jared VanderMeer, and I make digital tip episodes on YouTube almost every single day. I hope to see you guys in the next episode.